Hello friends, so I'm going to introduce an online portal which covers the following topics. The online portal name is SSmart. The main features are we can create or edit or manage course contents like we do in Google Classroom. I have tried to give more customized and controlled features. Next one is to create, add or edit the questions in the question bank. And whenever needed, we can set or schedule the exams. We can conduct the exams, take exam, and the assessment of the exams are automatic. Of course, the questions in the exams are objective questions. Next point is we can do the video streaming at the same portal. Okay. And while doing the streaming, we can the recording is automatic, it will be recorded. And text chatting is also there. Apart from that, two another features are being added. That is taking the attendance automatically, and on completion of the video streaming, we can trim the video or we can slice the video in smaller parts and save. That is still being done. So let's go to the portal. That is this is the link. You have to register. A small form is given, and then you have to log in. So in this section we can create the questions by selecting a department and the subject. If the subject is not already in the list, you can select other and you can give the subject name here. Here you have to write the questions, and also you can copy paste the image or diagrams here. For example, you have some questions or diagrams already. You can just snip it out wherever it is, and you may copy and paste here. So that image may be pasted here. You can remove also. Four choices you have to give, and each choice may have its own score. It may not be necessarily zero, but you may put 0.5, 0.2, 1, 2, whatever. This is the way, one by one, you can add several questions to a particular subject. Afterward, whenever needed, you can just view all the questions whatever you have added. Here few of the already questions are displayed, and if you want to schedule some exam, you have to select a set of questions. If required, you can edit also and save it. For scheduling the exam, you have to select year, semester, exam type, duration of the exam, dates and time, then schedule it. And the scheduled papers you can view here in scheduled papers. Like already I have scheduled some of the papers. At this point also, you can view the papers, what are the questions you have added, that you can see. Okay. And also, you can reschedule if you want by changing the date and time. If you click result, then you can see who are the students already have taken the exam and corresponding scores. You can see it. So this is all about the relating to question papers and exams. Next one is relating to the creating course contents. So here you can, by selecting department and subject, you can create the course. Once course is created, you can go to the edit page. In edit page, like some of the subjects course already created. In edit page, there are a set of buttons, plug and play. Like you click add chapter. So let us say in unit 1, I want to add a chapter 2. Okay, some topic name chapter 2, and click added. So a new chapter is added. Okay. Similarly, you can add the contents in chapter 1. Let us say add contents. Unit 1, chapter 2, let us say topic 1. So your new topic is added here. And now add the contents. In adding the contents, as of now, you may say it's as a limitation or features, in fact, that whatever text contents you have to keep it in your Google Drive and you have to give the link here. So just copy paste the same link here. And only the document ID you have to copy from your drive and paste here. So let us say I want to add it in unit 1, chapter 2. It is PPT and this is, let us say, PPT 1. So it is added. Now if you have a set of contents, there is a up and down cursor, you can rearrange the topics. If you click it, okay, the contents will appear in right side. And after all, you have to click save. So the contents will be saved. Oh, sorry. Okay. I'll check it. I'll show you the what are already saved. Okay, maybe some network problem. So in order to see the contents, you go in the view page. Okay, in the view page, there is a set of papers already developed. At this point, a student can register a particular course from this section. And in, if you go to the view course, look at these are the topics are added. Okay, you can click a particular topic and you can see the contents. The lecture plan is also added. So this is created by the same portal. So this is the look and feel for the view page where students can see. Okay, and edit page would be here. Okay, let us say this just now I have created, so I'll add one content here and I'll show you. So just copy paste. Let me see whether this YouTube link working. So I'm going to add it in unit 1, chapter 1. This is a video 1 topic name. So this is added here. So if you click the video, you can play here anywhere. So now you save it. It is saved now. Now going to the view in the C. So this video just now we have added. Okay. So here there is no buttons relating to edit. So this is all about the course related parts. Further, some features will be added based upon the feedback. Next one is streaming. Let us say you want to take the online class. So coming to this page, you have to set the stream name. What should be the name of the streaming? Let us say it is KK8 something. Now set. You have to permit the permission for the camera and audio. Okay, you can select the entire screen to be shared. So this is nothing but the screen part. This you can close as of now. And then you click start streaming. Once you click, streaming started. So streaming started at this time and date. Now students can view, in the same streaming section there is view stream button. Here also it is there. So if you click, okay, so this is the view where students can see the video. So student has to give the same streaming name here or room name, that is KK8. I had given KK8. So the same streaming name to be given here. Now click set. So it is started. Okay, so this is the streaming. Okay, in beginning once or twice replay button may be needed to be clicked. Now chatting can be done from here. Just say hello. Currently the streamer and this both are same. So hello. Okay, here hello came. Welcome to the session. And if you go in the participant, you can see here how many total participants connected and how many currently online. Apart from that, once you click stop at the end, then here you will be able to see the name of the participants and how much time spent, how many minutes and how many conversations are made for each participant. And I'm going to add one feature here. This by single click it will be saved in the database as a attendance, including how much time spent and how many conversations are made. Apart from that, whatever you have played streamed, you can replay from here. You can replay. And also you can download from here. Download link is there. One more feature I am going to add, that is once you replay, you may feel to split the video in few parts or you may cut out some of the parts. Means you can do the editing of the video and after editing you can save it at the server so that students can see that video from next time onwards. So those features soon will be added. So this is all about the streaming and okay, it is stopped because session completed. Okay. Here there are some different colors, like if someone is disconnected, connected, so it will show in different colors. Okay, so these are the features. Remaining on feedback, we shall try to add. Okay, thank you. So I'm going to stop this recording. Actually, it is also done by the same tool.